Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to discuss the differences between drilling, boring and reaming operation. So these are basically a machining operation and it is basically used for removing the material from the workpiece. So for classifying drilling, boring and reaming, I have prepared three columns and the figures below that three columns, those are nothing but the figures for drilling, boring and reaming respectively. Okay, so the very first point is drilling is performed to originate the hole. So here in this diagram you can see the very first diagram. This is the diagram. So in this diagram you can see a solid workpiece is there and drill bit is used for originating the hole in the workpiece. So drilling is used for making the cylindrical hole. Okay, so the drilling is performed to originate the hole. So initially the workpiece must be solid and then you have to use the drill bit to originate the hole. That is the purpose of drilling operation. Now the second operation, that is boring operation. So boring is performed to enlarge the diameter of existing hole. Okay, so here with the second diagram you can see the boring operation. For the boring operation, boring bar is used and basically the boring is performed to enlarge the diameter of existing hole. That means before boring operation you have to carry out a drilling operation and you have to prepare a hole. After that you can perform the boring operation, and boring operation is used to enlarge the diameter of that hole. Then the third operation, that is reaming. Reaming is performed to finish the hole surface and to improve the tolerance. So basically for reaming operation, again you have to drill the hole first and after that you have to perform reaming operation, and reaming operation is used to improve the surface finish of that drilled hole. That is the purpose of reaming operation. So with the help of these three diagram, the things are very much clear. For drilling operation, the workpiece must be solid. And then with the help of drill bit, you can start the process of drilling. So initially the workpiece will be solid. The second operation, that is boring. Boring operation is used to enlarge the diameter of previously drilled hole. That means there should be a previously drilled hole first and then you can enlarge the diameter with the boring operation. Then the last one, that is reaming operation. So reaming is used for finishing a previously drilled hole. Okay, so very less material is removed during a reaming operation and it is basically used to improve the surface finish of a drilled hole. So that is the first point. Now second point, cutting tool used for drilling is known as drill. So in the very first diagram you can see a drill bit, and the drill bit is used for a cutting operation or for drilling operation. Okay, so the cutting tool used for drilling is known as a drill bit. So here in this diagram you can see a drill bit. This is made up of high speed steel. So this drill bit has two cutting edges at its lower end. So at this point you can see the cutting edges. These are nothing but the cutting edges and it consists of flutes. So these flutes are used for removing the burr during the drilling operation, and again it is used to supply the lubricant during the drilling operation. So that is the purpose of flutes. So the drilling operation is performed with the help of this twist drill. Then the boring. Cutting tool used for the boring is known as boring bar. So here you can see the boring bar. This is known as boring bar, which is cylindrical in shape. So this is a boring bar which is cylindrical in shape and it has a cutting insert at the end. So it looks like a single point cutting tool, but its shape is cylindrical. Its shape must be a cylindrical because it has to pass through a cylindrical hole and it is basically used for enlarging the diameter of that hole. You can use this boring bar over a lathe machine. This boring bar is fixed to the turret of the lathe machine and then the boring bar has to enter inside a previously drilled hole, and ultimately you can increase its diameter by removing the material from the circumference of the hole. So this is the tool tip. This will come in contact with the workpiece and it will remove the material along the circumference of the hole. Then the third one, that is reaming. Cutting tool used for reaming is called as reamer. So here on this screen you can see the reamer. This is known as reamer and it has a cutting teeth over its periphery. These are nothing but its cutting teeth, its sharp edges, and with these sharp edges it can remove the material from the periphery of the hole or from the circumference of the hole. So this is nothing but a reamer. Okay, so the cutting tool used for drilling is known as drill bit, the very first figure. The cutting tool used for boring is known as boring bar, the second figure. And the cutting tool used for reaming is called as reamer, that is the third figure. Now the third point, drill is a double point cutting tool. Okay, so here in this diagram, this is nothing but a drill bit. Here you can see on the screen. And this drill bit has two cutting edges at its bottom end. These are nothing but cutting edges of this drill bit. So the twist drill has a two cutting edge at its bottom edge, and with this cutting edge it can remove the material. And these fluids are used for another purpose. So the cutting action is done by only these two edges. That is why the drill bit is a double point cutting tool, because the cutting action takes place with the help of these two cutting edges. Then the boring. Boring bar is a single point cutting tool. So here you can see the boring bar, and at the end of this boring bar the cutting insert is fixed with the help of screw, and the cutting action takes place with the help of these pointed ends, these three pointed ends. This is a triangular insert and which is attached firmly to the boring bar with the help of screw, and the cutting action takes place with the help of these three cutting edges. Okay, that means the boring bar uses a single point cutting tool for removing the material. Then reamer is nothing but a multi point cutting tool, because the cutting action takes place with the help of these cutting edges. So it has number of cutting edges, right? And it can remove the material along the periphery of the drilled hole. So again we will repeat this point. Drill is a double point cutting tool as it has two cutting edges at its bottom. Boring bar is a single point cutting tool because it is having only one edge, and with that it can remove the material. Reamer is a multi point because it has a number of points through which you can remove the material. Then the next point, drilling is first phase of hole fabrication. It does not require any special feature prior to operation. Okay. So drilling, we can say, is a first phase of hole fabrication, because initially you will have a solid material and then you can drill hole inside that solid material with the help of drill bit. Obviously you can perform centering operation before drilling operation to get a precise location, but that is not compulsory. So drilling is the first phase of hole fabrication. It is a start of fabrication process, or it is a start of you can say the machining process, and it does not require any special feature prior to the operation. That is about drilling. Then boring. A pre-drilled hole is mandatory for performing the boring. So here in second diagram you can see the hole is compulsory, then and then you can perform the boring operation. This boring bar will go inside this hole and it will enlarge its diameter. Okay, so boring bar will have a cutting edge at its end and it will go inside the previously drilled hole, and you can enlarge its diameter by removing the material along the periphery of the hole. So that is all about the boring. Then the third operation, that is reaming. Similar to boring, reaming can perform only if hollow part or hole exist. So the boring and reaming operation is quite similar, because you should have a previously drilled hole first, then and then you can perform either boring or the reaming operation. So boring is used for enlarging the diameter, whereas the reaming is used for finishing the hole. So very less material is removed along the periphery. You can remove the material along the periphery of the hole. So you can remove the material along the periphery of this hole. That material will be very less, But the condition is there should be a previously drilled hole first, then and then you can perform reaming operation or the boring operation. And these things are cleared with the help of these figures also. Then the next point, drilling can increase the length but not diameter. Okay, so with the help of drilling operation or with the help of drill bit, you can increase the length of the hole. So that is cleared with the help of this diagram. So this is a drilling operation. Here I am using a drill for drilling a hole. Okay, so we can give axial feed only, that means we can move the cutting tool in downward direction or in upward direction only. We cannot move the cutting tool along horizontal direction, this is not possible. Okay, we can move the cutting tool in linear direction or in vertical direction only. So axial feed can be given, and with that axial feed we can increase the length of this hole. We cannot increase the diameter of this hole. Okay, suppose we want to increase the diameter, then we have to use the drill bit with more diameter, right? But with this diameter we can only increase the length of a hole. Okay, so drilling can increase the length but not diameter, that is limited to drill diameter, right? Then boring can increase the diameter of existing hole but not length. So here this is nothing but boring operation. Here you can see the workpiece is fixed inside the chuck and it is rotating, and this is the boring tool. This is the boring tool, and with this boring tool we are increasing the diameter of the workpiece, right? So there should be a hole inside the workpiece, and that is done with the help of drilling operation. Then we have to pass this boring bar inside the workpiece, and that can increase its diameter because it can remove the material along the periphery. So with boring operation we can only increase the diameter but we cannot increase the length of the hole, and that is get cleared with this diagram. Then the third operation, that is reaming. So in case of reaming, neither diameter nor length can be increased substantially by the reaming. So with reaming, basically it is not expected to increase the diameter or to increase the length with the help of reaming operation, because it is a finishing operation. Only less material can be removed, so very less material along the periphery of the hole is removed, so it is not expected to increase the diameter or the length with the help of reaming operation. We can machine the material up to 0.25 mm. So 0.25 mm is the only depth of cut that can be given during reaming operation, and it is a super finishing, or we can say it's a finishing operation. So that is the difference in between drilling, boring and reaming. So drilling can increase the length but not diameter, boring can increase the diameter but not length, whereas neither diameter nor length can be increased substantially by reamings. Here the word substantially is very important, because somewhat material is removed during reaming operation and diameter get increased, but not substantially. That is very important. Then the next point is, surface quality of drill hole is not very good. So with the first diagram it can be clear. So the surface quality of drill hole is not very good. You will not get a good quality surface with the help of drilling operation. That is why other operations are required after drilling, that is the reaming operation or honing operation can be performed to improve its surface characteristics. Okay, so with drilling operation surface quality is not good. Then the second point, that is boring, surface quality is better than drilling. So here I have, with this first and second diagram it can be clear. Here in the first diagram you can see the surface quality is very poor, whereas in second diagram you can see the surface quality is better as compared to your drilling operation, right? Then talking about reaming produces highly finished surface, because reaming is a process of finishing operation. So reaming is a finishing operation, so the reaming produces highly finished surface. Here in this diagram you can see a highly finished surface you are getting with the help of these reamers. So the reamer produces highly finished surface, and that is not possible with boring and drilling operation, as the reaming is finishing operation and it removes very less material during cutting. Now the last point, that is the material removal rate, that is MRR, in drilling operation is higher. So here in this diagram, the first diagram shows the drilling operation and the chips get removed, and that chip can be removed with the help of these flutes. Okay, so the material removal rate is higher in case of drilling. The second one, that is boring, material removal rate is lower than drilling but higher than reaming. Okay, so here this diagram is showing the drilling operation. So the tool is rotating in clockwise direction, and you can give the radial feed as well as the axial feed, and this is a boring tool. And as the material is removed with the help of single point only, so the material removal rate is less as compared to drilling. Here there are two cutting edges, that is why obviously more material removal rate you will get as compared to the boring operation, because in boring operation single point cutting tool is used. So as compared to drilling, very less material is get removed. Then the third one, that is reaming, material removal rate is poor. In fact, material removal rate is not an issue in the reaming. Okay, so with this diagram you can see the reaming operation. So here this is the feed direction and this is the reamer, it is rotating, and this one is the workpiece. So very less material is removed as compared to boring as well as drilling. In fact, that is not the criteria, because we are not interested in removing the material. We are interested in highly finished surface, and that is possible with reaming only. Okay, so I hope you have understood the difference between drilling, boring and reaming with these slides. So once again we will repeat in short. So the very first, drilling is performed to originate the hole. Boring is used to enlarge the hole. Reaming is performed to finish the hole. For drilling, drill bit is used. For boring, boring bar is used. And for reaming, reamer is used. Drill is a double point cutting tool. Boring is a single point cutting tool, whereas reamer is multi point cutting tool. Drilling is a first phase of operation, whereas a pre-drilled hole is required in boring. And similar to boring, again reaming can be performed only if hollow part or the hole is exist. Then drilling can increase the length but not diameter. Boring can increase the diameter but not length. Neither diameter nor length can be increased substantially by reaming. Then surface quality of the drill hole is very poor, is not good. Surface quality is better than drilling in case of boring. Then reaming produces highly finished surface. The last one, material removal rate in case of drilling is very high. Material removal rate in boring is lower than drilling, and material removal rate in reaming is very poor. In fact, material removal rate is not an issue in reaming. So thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you.